Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. We begin with that snowstorm now bearing down on New Hampshire. It could dump more than a foot of snow up north, much less down south with more of a mix of rain and snow. Ray Brewer has been tracking this storm and tells us road crews are gearing up. Schools are already sending students home. He has the story from Danbury.
Wednesday morning and the plows were out in Danbury as the snow started to fall. The area is expecting possibly a foot of snow by the time the storm finally winds down. At the elementary school, the students only had half a day.
We're such a rural community and we've got a lot of mountain roads and high hills, so to get the kids off the road safely and early. I think we're all winter weary.
You can include Donna Hamlin and 10-year-old Scott in that group as they gingerly made their way down the driveway.
It's pretty icy. And the snow is making it worse.
Their van is unable to make it up the steep driveway.
It stops right about there at that first hill there. So we hike every day.
But not everyone is ready for warmer weather. Stephen Strait was filling up tanks with diesel fuel for his job, glad for the continued winter.
It helps me with my work as I'm a logger. I like the ground to stay frozen.
At Ragged Mountain, they're also enjoying the frozen ground. The storm is expected to bring a heavy wet snow here and then change to a lighter snow.
We have a lot of glades here, which are all open, but it really sets those up well with base.
A golf course at the mountain is a sign that warmer weather is a possibility, but now it's covered with snow. And Bob Ashton says they're willing to hold off on breaking out the clubs.
We're not quite ready for that. That can come in April, and we normally don't start our golf season until May anyway.
And there are more than 100 closings right now. Some of those are town meetings. Plymouth, Campton, and Sandwich have already postponed. For more, you can check here on our website, WMUR.com, for a full list. Now to some of those key votes that we have been following. In Hooksett, voters have shot down a contract to send their high school students to Pinkerton Academy. Some students will still be going there next year as part of a trial agreement, but what happens after that is unclear. Newmarket voters shot down a new junior-senior high school but approved $800,000 for renovations. Salem approved more than $74 million for high school renovations, and Danville has re-elected Police Chief Wade Parsons. Parsons has been charged with negligently storing his gun after his girlfriend's son used it to kill himself. He has asked that those charges be dropped. Well, now to a massive fire in downtown Lancaster. These images were sent in to us by viewers. You can see flames shooting from the roof of this building on Main Street. The fire started around 7 this morning and went to 2 alarms. There's no word yet on what caused that fire. Republican Joe Kenney of Wakefield is claiming victory in the race to fill Ray Burton's seat on the Executive Council. Democrat Michael Kryans has conceded the race. The Secretary of State's office says official results should be available this afternoon. District 1 covers more than 100 communities across the northern half of the state. Starting tonight at 5, we will have team coverage of this storm hitting New Hampshire today. And an update on the developing news out of New York City, where a building has collapsed, killing at least 2 people. This is officials here giving an update on the conditions there. We'll have much more on that starting at 5. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.